All right, Tom, thank you. We have some good news tonight for a snowboarding star hospitalized with a traumatic brain injury. 22-year-old Kevin Pierce is no longer in critical condition. A spokeswoman for Pierce's family says the Olympic hopeful has improved to serious condition. Pierce, a Norwich, Vermont native, suffered a brain injury while training for Olympic qualifying events last week in Utah.
And Gus, the severity of Kevin Pierce's injury is making some riders think twice when it comes to protecting their heads while on the mountain. News Channel 5's Mia Moran is live in the Vermont newsroom tonight with more on that part of the story. Mia.
Well, Stephanie, helmet use on the slopes has been a hot-button issue among skiers and snowboarders for a long time. Some say they're uncomfortable and bulky, while others believe they save lives.
For longtime snowboarder Mary Simmons, wearing a helmet on the mountain is second nature.
Now, after so many years, I feel kind of naked without my helmet. It's also warm.
The hardware is something Simmons has in common with countless other snowboarders, including professional rider Kevin Pierce.
So Kevin definitely has the skills here.
The Vermont native fell hard during a training run last week in Salt Lake City and severely injured his brain, despite the fact that he was wearing a helmet. Pierce's injury hasn't made snowboarders like Trevor Borelli and Sky Gale, who don't protect their heads, think twice. They argue injuries while snowboarding come with the territory.
Going that big as they do at that Olympic level, like when they knock their head, they're going to knock themselves out. It's just the sport. That's what happens.
With football, they're having talks of like high concussion rates, and it's going to happen with this and snowboarding if you have a helmet on or not.
But Fletcher Allen doctor Rob Williams, who's become an advocate for helmet use, disagrees.
There's no downside whatsoever to wearing a ski helmet, and if you have a helmet on, the odds are much better that you're going to survive an accident if not.
He says head injuries on the mountain could be cut in half if more people wore helmets. But until ski resorts start mandating helmets, wearing one will remain a personal choice.
And I think it's important that it...
Now, Trevor Borelli and Sky Gale did say while they support people who wear helmets, the hardware just isn't for them. Live in the Vermont newsroom, Mia Moran, News Channel 5. Back to you.